Hey everybody, Mr. Odom here, and today I'm going to cover section 6.5, percents of increase and decrease. So you'll need the usual goodies, your pencil, your composition book, notebook paper, and definitely for this section, 6.6, 6.7, you will need your calculator handy next to you, ready to go. All right, the learning target for this video is I can find percents of increase and percents of decrease. There's a lot of definitions in this section, so at times I'll ask you guys to write some things down in your composition book, so just be ready to do that. So let's get started. The first definition that I want you to write in your composition book is a percent of change. A percent of change is the percent that a quantity changes from its original amount. And this is a general formula that you can use to find the percent of change. So pause the video right now and go ahead and write that definition in your composition book. All right, we're back. I forgot to say, if you're watching Edpuzzle, it'll pause now, but that's okay, you got it. All right, so now that we have this definition, what if the percent of change, what if the change was an increase? Then there's a specific formula for that. And what if the change was a decrease? Well, there's a specific formula for that as well. And they are right here. So when the original amount, whatever that original amount is, when it increases, the percent of change is called a percent of increase. And here is the formula for that. It's right here. Okay. And I use these little, what do we call these things? Letters. Yeah, that's what we call them. So that you don't, when you write the formula down, you don't have to write percent of increase equals new amount minus original amount divided by original amount. That's a lot to say. All right. So instead of percent of increase, I do P, capital P, little I. For new amount, we'll just use N. For original amount, O. And original amount, the denominator, O. So percent of increase formula that I want you to use is that one, okay? For the percent of decrease, when that original amount decreases, the percent of change is called a percent decrease. And so I use capital P, little d for that, and then the O and the N and the O are still the same. Original amount for O, new amount for N, okay? So we have this formula to use. All right, so if you're watching this on YouTube, please pause the video, and I'd like you to write these formulas down and these definitions, and then come on back. If you're watching this in Edpuzzle, the video will pause now. All right, so we're back. Let's look at some examples. Let's see this stuff in action. All right, so here's a problem for us. It says, the table shows the number of hours you spent online last weekend. What is the percent of change? So sometimes a problem's going to say, what's the percent of change? And it's up to you to determine whether that change was an increase or it was it a decrease? Okay, so you really got to pay attention to the problem. So this one says, what is the percent of change in your online time from Saturday to Sunday? That's important information. So we're going from what we did on Saturday to what we did on Sunday. Okay. So if we're going from 2 hours to 4.5 hours, is that an increase or is that a decrease? All right, very good. That is an increase. So since it's an increase, we need to use the percent of increase formula. Woohoo! All right, so let's do it. Let's try it out. So percent of increase equals the new amount minus the original amount divided by the original amount. Okay, so since we're going from Saturday to Sunday, my original amount will be whatever the hours were on Saturday. And then on Sunday, that would be the new amount. Okay, so my original amount will be 2 hours. The new amount will be 4.5. So let's put this in here. I have 4.5 minus 2 divided by 2. Okay, and 4.5 minus 2 gives us what? 2.5 divided by 2. And you can put that in your calculator, 2.5 divided by 2, or some of you with more smarts than me already know that that's 1.25. Now here's the deal. This has to be written as a percent. It's called the percent of increase. So we need to look at this number and we need to turn it into a percent. And remember how we do that? We move the decimal in which direction? Exactly, two places, one, two to the right. So this is 125%. So basically, this says from Saturday to Sunday, the amount of time you spent on your computer increased by 125%. Okay, so that's how we can find the percent of change. Let's look at these problems. So I'll do one and then you guys do one. All right. So I'm going to look at number two. Number two, we're going from 57 people to 65 people. That looks like an increase to me. So I'm going to use the percent of increase formula, and that equals the new amount minus the original amount divided by the original amount. So here is my original amount. That is my new amount. So I take 65, I subtract 57, I divide it by 57. 65 minus 57, blah, 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 8 over 57. This is where the calculator comes in handy because I don't know what 8 divided by 57 is. I don't keep that handy in my head. But I get this really long decimal. I'll write some of it down. It's 0.14035877. I imagine it's going to keep going on and on. All right. So now we have to pay attention to the directions. It says round to the nearest tenth of a percent, if necessary. All right. So first I need to turn this into a percent. So as a percent, this is going to equal, I need to move the decimal two places to the right, 14.035877, and probably goes on forever. So if I want to round to the nearest tenth, I need to round to that point there, okay? And you guys remember how to round. I need to look next door at this number. It's 4 or below, so I do not increase the 0. So now this is an approximation, approximately 14%. Okay, so the video is going to stop now if you're watching this on Edpuzzle. I want you guys to work out problem number one, and we'll come right back with the answer. All right, so now you can see the solution to problem number one right here. Percent of increase, because we're going from 10 to 25. Here's my original amount. There's my new amount. I'll just plug the numbers in. All right, so the math for the section is really not too difficult. All right. Let's look at another example. So this bar graph shows a softball player's home run totals. Okay, what was the percent of change? So we have to figure out, is it an increase or decrease from 2012 to 2013? So we're looking here, we're looking at 2012 to 2013. So how many home runs did they have in 2012? Well, they had 28 of them. How many in 2013? They had 20 of them, right? So this is my original amount here, and this is my new amount. And it looks like a decrease. So we're going to use the percent decrease formula. All right. So the percent of decrease equals the original amount minus the new amount divided by the original. And I just plug them in. So my original was 28. My new was 20. And I divide by the original, which is 28. Okay. So this is 8 over 28. And in my calculator, I'm probably going to get another long decimal, 0.285714. And it turns out that this is a repeating decimal. And so we need to turn this into a percent. So we'll just say it's about 28.6, and I'm going to use the approximation symbol, not equals. So this percent of decrease is approximately 28.6%. Okay. So this guy better watch out, his home run totals are dropping, right? Maybe he's getting old. Okay. So that's how you use the percent decrease formula. Let's talk about another concept, percent of error. All right. So I'm going to pause the video here if you're watching an Edpuzzle, and I want you to write down this definition in your composition book with the formula. Okay. So it's going to pause now. All right. So we're back, and hopefully you wrote that in your composition book. So how do I write this? So I don't like writing the whole formula down. So what I like to do is I'll call this PE, percent of error. And for the amount of the error, I use capital A and little e. And the actual amount, I use capital A and little a. Okay, so that is how I can write the formula without writing all the words. So it'll be percent of error equals the amount of the error divided by the actual amount. And this is important. Your error is always going to be a positive number. So your error will be, it's a 16% error. And we're going to look at an example and see how this works. So you estimate. So that's a key word. You're guessing, right? That's what estimating means. You're guessing that the length of your classroom is this much, all right? But the actual length is 21 feet. So that word actual should key you in that 21 feet is going to be the actual amount, okay? And so we need to calculate the percent of error. So we need to find this amount of the error and divide it by the actual amount. And so the amount of the error, the way we calculate that is we take the larger number, always the larger number, and we subtract the smaller one, okay? So in this case, your estimate is smaller than the actual amount. Sometimes your estimate will be larger than the actual amount. And then that would come first in the percent error in the numerator, because you always want to have a positive answer. Okay. So, and the actual amount was 21 feet. So there's my percent error. And I end up with 5 over 21. And you can put that in your calculator and we can round it. So this is about, let's see, 23.8%. And I got to start using my approximation sign. It's approximately this, because this really goes on forever. Okay, so a couple more problems. In example 2, what was the percent of change from 2010 to 2011? So let me put that, let's go grab that information. So 2010 to 2011, so we went from 18 to 10, okay? So percent of change from, we went from 18 was our original amount, and our new amount is 10. Okay, so that's problem 3. And so for problem 4, what if your friend estimates that the length of the classroom is 23 feet? So now that's bigger than the actual amount. Okay, so the percent of error is going to be 23 minus 21 divided by 21. Because remember, the room, the actual amount was 21 feet. All right. So this is just 2 over 21. So we can see how good your friend's guess was. So 2 divided by 21. And this is about approximately 9.5%. Okay. For number 3, here's your original amount and your new amount. So we would use the percent of decrease formula, which says I take my original amount, I subtract my new amount, and I divide by the original. So this is 18 minus 10 divided by 10. And I end up with 8 over 10, right? 8 over 10. And so this is 0.8, which is 80%. All right. And so for this problem here, for number 3, I actually made a mistake, and this happens quite a bit. So here was my mistake. Remember, the original amount was 18. That goes in the denominator. Look what I put in the denominator, right? So that's not correct. So I got to fix that. All right. So this should be the original amount. The original amount should be 18, and that's 18. So now in my calculator, 8 divided by 18 is this. It's not 80%. It's going to be approximately, let's see here, approximately 44.4%. So you got to be careful. So it's good that I made that mistake so you guys could see that that happens quite a bit. Anyway, hopefully this video was helpful. And if you got questions, don't hesitate to ask. I'm here to help. All right. This is Mr. Odom, and I'm out.